Hello everybody and welcome back to Full-Time Living and Learning at St. Joseph's. It's a great time to be back together, knowing that we enjoy everything that is good about spring and the fact that we can enjoy each other's company for the remaining 7 or 8 weeks of school. A couple of announcements to start with, first being the announcement of Father Michael's retirement. So Father Michael has been with us in our parish, supporting our parish school and community for 9 years, and in February he turned 79. So it's great news for him to be able to head off into retirement. He'll be living in Shepparton, so not too far away, but great news. So congratulations, Father Michael. Secondly, our new staff have been appointed for next year. Jeremy Tyndall joins us in the classroom teaching ranks, and Ruth Hartnett Carr returns to us after some time in Townsville. She comes back with her family and she'll start at the beginning of term two, managing that very large role of special needs and the like. So we welcome those now and certainly, obviously, at the start of next year. I move on to talk about our new world back together and the requirements of COVID and the like in and around our school. We really need to be smart about how we go about our business at school. If we're clever and a step ahead, we can minimise the circle of close contacts that are created if and when COVID comes to our school. And the chances are quite reasonable. So we just need to be thinking ahead and making sure we do everything right so that if and when this happens, we just do what needs to be done, get on with it, and we're all back together very quickly. So in terms of what needs to be done, parents, unfortunately, it's a time to stay off site. For staff, we model and implement healthy practices in and around our school, and we ask our boys and girls to make our new healthy practices a part of what the new norm is. If we do this and COVID comes to our school, then what the reality is that we have a minimal personal close contact list. We may have a class or two that needs to test and isolate rather than the whole school. So, albeit a little bit difficult for a period, it does mean in the longer term that it's better for our whole community. So, as I say, if we're smart and a step ahead, we minimise the list of close contacts so the likelihood of a full or partial closure is kept to a minimum. Otherwise, it is great to have all the boys and girls back again. We have labelled week 7 as our big outdoor education week, where we have booked our seniors, our middles, and our junior sleepover. And by then, we're hoping that everything will be all clear. Otherwise, as soon as restrictions continue to be eased, we will continue to step up and make every post a winner on being able to do all those types of things that we may have missed out on through the year. So I look forward to a full week here at our school, and then we take a breath to enjoy our long Melbourne Cup weekend and then back into it for the run-in to our Christmas break. So good to see you all, and we look forward to continued good times here at St. Joseph's. Thank you and goodbye.
Welcome to our assembly. We are very excited and thankful to be here today, knowing that the whole school is back together. The last 2 years have been very difficult for all of us, and because of this, many people focused on the negative rather than all the good things in their lives. Today for our assembly, we are focusing on gratitude.
Gratitude is defined as the quality of being thankful. A readiness to show appreciation for our blessings and an opportunity to return kindness to others. The benefits of practicing gratitude are nearly endless. People who regularly practice gratitude by taking time to notice and reflect upon things they're thankful for experience more positive emotions, feel more alive, sleep better, express more compassion and kindness, and even have stronger immune system.
So how can we practice gratitude? A simple method is to stop, look, and go. Stop, get quiet, and slow down. create little stop signs in your life to remind you. Look, open your eyes and all your other senses to enjoy what is given to us. Go, take the opportunity and go with it. Enjoy it and pass it to others. The most important thing is finding the time to reflect on your day, on your life, and the things and the people in it who bring you joy.
I am grateful for my family and for having a roof over my head.
I'm grateful for being back at school and for being able to see my friends again.
I am grateful for all of the healthcare workers who have constantly put their lives on pause to help us, and for the scientists who have worked on cures.
There are many examples in the Bible of being grateful. In the book of Psalms, we hear the words, "Worship him with thankful hearts and a song of praise. With thankful hearts, offer up your prayers. Rejoice always, pray continually, give thanks in all circumstances."
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Today I give thanks for the blessing you've given me, for the kind people you've placed in my path, the beauty that exists all around me, and for the million gentle mercies and graces that are a part of each fresh new day. I sing your praises, Lord. So very grateful to have you in my life. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you for listening to our prayer.
This week's student of the week are
Senior N, Xavier, for continuing to be such a great help in the classroom. You are so considerate. From Senior H, Mia, for her kind and gentle manner. We love having you at St. Joseph's. For Senior M and I, Tom, for the leadership and passion he shows toward digital technologies. Your eagerness to share that with others is great. Well done. From Senior S, Connor, for his stellar return to online on-site learning. We are loving your engaged attitude. From Middle H, Steele, for working so hard finishing James and the Giant Peach and sharing his favourite parts. From Middle O, Rick, for making good choices in the classroom. It is great to see you trying your best with your work. From Middle B, Emma, for always showing a persistent and motivated attitude towards every learning task. From Middle W, Jaden, for his amazing efforts in literacy recently. Well done, Jaden. Keep it up. From Junior S, Lilith, for her increased willingness to accept challenges during writing. Well done, Lil. From Junior A, Ivani, for doing her best to improve her learning. So pleasing to see Ivani. Junior H, Max, for working so hard on your writing and reading. Your persistence is showing in the work you are producing. Keep it up, Max. From Junior J, Nate, for working well on all writing tasks and improving his reading skills. Awesome effort, Nate. From Prep M, Charlie, for his improved work ethic and listening skills. Well done, Charlie. From Prep N, Charlotte, for her growing confidence in reading and writing and working hard on improving her handwriting.
This week's social skill is tolerance, attitude, acceptance of differences, awareness that we are all different, action, treating others as you would like to be treated.
From seniors, Lucas, Caitlin, Ben, Audrey. From middles, Riley, Izzy, Phoebe, Noah. From juniors, Jessica, Mia, Indy, Kobe. And from prep, Jack and Charlie.
Starting term 4 here at St. Joseph's, our summer uniform is really important. Ollie is wearing his polo top, shorts, navy blue socks, and his all black shoes. And his hair styled nicely.
Emma is wearing a checkered skirt with white socks, black shoes, and St. Joseph's colours.
tell you in my own special way that you're extra special, so have a great day.
Hello everybody, it's great to see all different sporting clubs and the like starting to get organised to include our boys and girls in those activities that we haven't been able to enjoy over the recent weeks and months. One of those that has continued a little, doing the very best they can, was the Numurkah Show. So that would have been last Wednesday, but our group at the Numurkah Show actually continued to organise some of the little competitions, and one of those was the colouring competition. And I have the pleasure of awarding some first place blue ribbons to two of our students. The first one is Violet Richardson. Well done, Violet. Come in. Come around. Give Mum and Dad a big wave. Good girl. You take those. Congratulations. And, excuse me, a second award, similarly, another blue ribbon. For some beautiful colouring in, goes to Job Morris. Well done, Job. Good job. There's your certificate, and there's your beautiful blue ribbon. We give Mum and Dad and everyone a wave. Good job, mate. Well done. Thanks, everybody.